Hi, welcome back. I hope you're having fun with ClickFunnels tool and I hope you're learning a lot. In this video, we're going to learn how to create a website. And this is why I love ClickFunnels, because you can create a website. Just imagine, you know, it's you can actually monetize. You can start monetizing. You can develop website for people. And this is a very good platform to do that, right? It's very easy to create websites. And this is what we're going to learn today. Right, so let's get started. We'll go for a new funnel process, and let's say let's go for a product launch, website making. I'd go just create some tag out of it, and let's start building our funnel. All right, okay, there's too many over here, but any which way, I'm just gonna go let's say start with a blank page. All right. Yes, opt-in blank page is what I want. I'll just go and create an opt-in email opt-in blank page. Let's edit the page and get started. Now, what does a website usually contain? First of all, it will have a logo on the left, and on top it will have a navigation bar. This is what we want to start with, right? So let's create that format first. Okay, I'm going to start fresh. Let's add a new section. Let's keep it full width. I'm going to add a row to it, which is nothing but two columns. Okay, so two columns here, and so that left one could be for the logo. This part could be the logo, this could be the navigation bar. All right, so I don't want that big a logo, so I'm going to reduce it a bit. Here I'm going to add an image to it, right? So image is generated. Let's put our own logo here. Okay. Let's search for logo. So as you all know, it's freely generated. You can, it's a royalty free pictures. You can always use it. So let's use this particular one. Looks good. So let's add it. And voila, this here, right? Looks huge. So you might want to reduce the size a bit. Okay, let's keep it 20. Too small. 40. Too small. Let's give it 80. Okay, looks okay. Yeah, let's go ahead with that. Next would be now here you have to add a navigation bar to it. Okay, so if we adding a navigation bar, let's say there you go. Yes, so this you can make changes over here. These are the link text. If you, let's say, a navigation bar usually has an about page, about company page, contact us form and everything. And here is the link URL. You can directly, you know, the way to go about creating a website is you can create n number of funnels. Yeah, you can create an about me page, like a funnel of it. And you can just come and, you know, paste the URL over here. So what happens is when somebody clicks on this particular about me section, he will be diverted to the ClickFunnels page where you've written about the about me section. So this is how you can create pages on pages, and you can link with this one, right? So this is how it is. And if, let's say, you want to add some more, okay, you go to advanced section, you can create the number of links. So I want to keep it 5, you can keep it 4, you can keep it 2 links. Okay, so this is how you can add more links to it. So this is how you are let's keep it in a line with the logo. Yeah, now it's pretty much aligned. So this is how you create your header. Now, pretty much same concept, you might want to have a footer as well, right? So let's add a new section and let's add a footer to it. Okay, now footer, I just want to keep one element to it. That's it. Not want to add too many things over here. So let's say privacy policy, right? And we can say copyright, your business name 2019, right? And you can just click on this privacy policy, you can create a link, and you can add the website over here. This is how you go about it, right? And so amazing, so easy as well. So this is my footer, this is my header. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna save this as a template, right? I'm gonna save it as a header, and I'm gonna save this section. Woo, done. I'm gonna save this again. I'm gonna save this section again. So let's say footer. Done, right? So what I can do is the header and footer is done. And why am I saving it is because header and footer is pretty much common in every page you create. You would have seen any website the header and footer remains constant. So what happens is when somebody, now this is your home page, you can add images, you can add videos, you can create n number of things over here, and you can create separate funnels for about me section, pricing, order now, about us, resources as well. Okay, just to put some perspective, let's save it. Okay, I'm gonna go back and I'm gonna create let's say another step, which is about me section. Okay, and I'm gonna create the funnel here, and when I come here, let's say let's go to sales page, and maybe I want to select, let's say, this one. So I'm gonna select this particular template over here, and this is about me section. Let's, for the sake of saying, let's say this is an about me section, and here I want to add my header and footer. How do I do that? So first of all, I have to add a section. Okay, here's where I'm gonna add a section. And I think you don't even have to add a section over here. You can directly go to the add section part here. You can go to my sections and you can put the header over here. And boom, guys, this is generated, right? This is so awesome, don't you think? And then again, you can do the same thing. So yeah, this I love this tool for the fact that it's so easy, and you know, just drag and drop stuff, right? And then footer is also here, and this we have linked it as well to another ClickFunnels page. So this is how you create websites on website. It could be a great monetary benefit for you if you actually master this one. So I leave it up to you. You go master this particular aspect of it, how to create websites, and it's gonna be a game changer for you guys. So thank you so much for watching this video, and I'm gonna see you in next video.